Hi student, in today's tutorial we will discuss concept of attributes. In as we are discussing concept of entity relationship model, and previous two video one we discuss concept of entity, component of entity type or entity, then we are in what is entity type, what is entity set, and then what is the entity instance. After this we discuss concept of types of entity type, strong entity type and weak entity type. If you have any problem, you can view all of those videos. Today we will discuss concept of attributes. As we see that entity type is collection of entity that share the common properties, that is called entity type. Now what is the attribute? The property associated with entity type, that is called attribute. Whenever we are having entity type, over there we are having collection of that share the common properties, and over here we see the property associated with entity type, that is called attribute. Properties are characteristics of entity type or relationship that is of the interest of organizations. Let one entity type is available. Name of entity type is here student. Student, what are the properties of students? We see that student ID, student name, student email, phone number, address, location, things like that. These are the properties of student. So these are the attributes. The properties associated with entity type, that is called attribute. So here we see that whenever entity type is here, entity type is here student. So whenever we are having entity type is here student, so what are the properties of this one? Here is student ID, student name, phone number, email. These are the properties of the that are associated with entity type. So these are the attributes. Like teacher, teacher ID, teacher name, teacher qualification, these are the properties of teacher entity. So now how we can represent? Graphical representation method of attributes. When we see that we are having entity type, to represent the entity type we see that we are having the rectangle, we are having the box, and within the box we have to represent the entity types. That we are having entity type name is here student, that must be a capital. That is now how we can represent the attributes. So for that one we are having the way to represent the attributes. How we see that whenever we are having attributes, we have, let's say, having entry type name is here, then we are having the different types of attributes are available. So here we see that whenever we are having attributes, entry type name should be here within the rectangles. Then we are having the attribute, list of attributes, what are the different attributes are there, what are the different properties of there, identifiers, and partial identifier, optional, derived, multi-value, composite, and other type of attributes are available. So whenever we are having attributes, that we are having n type is here student. So first one we have to use it over here, the name of the entry type std. Then attribute identifier, let me say that is a property, student ID. That is the one attribute. Then similarly we are having another attribute, student name. So here we are having the two different notations of two different notation are used to represent the attribute. One is we are having the chain database notations, and second we are having the CRO-FOOT database notations. And CRO-FOOT notations we are having entity type name is here. Let me draw it in Microsoft Visio. The name of this one is shares, that must be in the capital letters. Then attribute, then we are having another attribute, like we are having the student names, then we are having the student. Address. So here we are having the entry type is available and having the different type of attributes are available over here. So in this way we can represent the attribute over here. Now how we can represent then naming the attribute? Whenever we are having attribute is here, initial capital letter followed by the lowercase letters. So here whenever we are using, so here we see that attribute name is here, that must be initial capital letter. Let me add the new attribute over here. Let me say phone. So here initial word is capital followed by the lowercase letters. Right. We are having student name. Here we can use it over here as name. If attribute consists of the two word, then use underscore character to connect the words and then start each word with the capital letter. Like here we set as student address, or instead of S names, if we can use it over here, student S is capital, TD is followed by lowercase letter and names. So in this way we can represent the attributes. Student name, initial capital followed by lowercase letter. If we are having the two words, here E capital followed by the lowercase letter. If we are having two words, we have to use underscore symbols, that is used to combine to, that is used to connect with the two words, and then initial word is capital over here. S is capital and N is capital over here. Now we are having domain of an attribute. Set a possible value for an attribute is called domain. Domain can be used for boundaries check. Attribute is an entity set, get the value for the same domains. So when we are having attribute is there, we are having the different types of attributes, required attribute and optional attribute. Attribute, required attribute, we see that attribute that must have a value for every instance, that is called required attribute. Optional attribute, the attribute that may not have a value for every entity instance. Attribute without a value is said to be a null value. Mean, whenever we are having the required attribute, you must have a value, student names, address, date of birth. But if you say fixed numbers, it's not necessary that for all the students must have a fixed numbers. So that is a optional attribute. So over here we are having the constraints. Whenever we are having the required attributes, for that one we must have a constraint over there, not null. And whenever we are having optional attributes, that is having the default value null value. If we have value, it's okay. If you don't have value, then fine. Right. Here attribute student ID, require attribute name, address, home city and zip code, require attribute. But imagine that is the optional. Here one student instance must have a value for this one, MIS, that is having a value for the measures. But here for second one student we don't have a value, so that is an option. If you have value, that is okay. If you don't have value, no problem is yes. So measure is the optional attribute, all the other are the required attributes. So another type is here, we are having simple attribute and composite attribute. Attribute that simple attribute, the attribute that cannot be broken down into the smaller part or component. That we are having one attribute is here, student C, that is 5000. Student marks, So we may not be able to break it down. We may not be able, that cannot be broken down into the smaller part or components. Attribute have a single value, that is called simple attributes. So these are the simple attributes, C and marks. Composite attribute that can be broken down into meaningful component. Let we are having attribute is here name. We are having attribute address. So name can be broken down into smaller components, meaningful component. Those components are F names and last name. First names, last names. Whenever we are having composite attribute, or we can represent composite attributes in the, let me check it over here in the Microsoft video. Over here, like we are having student names, we use it over here. So whenever we are having the composite attribute, or we can represent, we have to use it over here, the parenthesis, and then component. What components are here? F name. And we are having the last names. So these are the two components over here. If we are having address, so what are the components of address? That is, we say that component of this one is here, city, state, country, province and others. That is a composite attribute. Now, if here we are using the Crowfitted, if we are using the chain database notations, and chain database notations, if this one is a Crowfitted notations, if you are having the chain notations, so entity is represented over here, that entity name is here student, or I am using it over another employee, that must be a capital letter. Okay, now we are having attributes. Attribute over there in the chain database notations, we have to use it over here, the like this one over is used, and here we have to add the names of this one attributes, that attribute at edit. Okay, let me say that student ID. Okay, then we are having student names. Right click, and then we are having the edit text, student names. As you see that this one is a composite attribute that can be broken down. So in chain database notation, how we can represent it? For that one, to represent this one, we have to use it over here. Other component over here, let me draw it over here. Okay, another components, let me say that's text, and then we here we see that what we are having F name, and here see I have to use it over here L names, last name. So in this way we may be able to represent the composite attribute in the chain database notation. And if you are using it over here Crowfitted, then for that one we have to use it over here attribute name followed by parentheses, and then components, simple component, meaningful components separated by comma and closed within a parenthesis. So that is a composite attribute. And here we are having student ID. That is a simple attribute. Here we are having student ID. That is a simple attribute. Okay. Now, graphical here employee address. It's that is enclosed within a parenthesis separated by comma. Street address, city, state, province, and so on. That is the representation of the composite attribute. Now, our name, that is the composite attribute, first name, middle name, last names, address, state, city, state. Now we are having single value attribute and multi-value attribute. Whenever we are having this concept of a single value attribute, the attribute that may take a single value for a given entity instance. student ID, registration numbers, names. That is having, so one student is having only one name. Student may take a single value for a given entity instance. For one instance, we are having only one value. Student names, one. Address, CNC numbers. So that is a single value attribute. And then we are having the multi-value attributes. Attribute that may take more than one value for a given instance. Like, here let's be having the subject. Skill. Let student is having one attribute. That is a subject. So subject, one student may have more than one subject. So subject is a multi-value attribute. Attribute that may take more than one value for a given instance. How we can we see that subject is a multi-value attribute. Now, whenever we are having subject multi-value attribute, how we can represent it? Multi-value attribute. To represent the multi-value attribute, we have to use it over here. Curly braces. That are used to represent the multi-value attribute. Let me show it over here in Microsoft Visio. That is a crow-footed. So another, add another attribute. That we are having the subject attribute. How we can represent it? That is a multi-value attribute. So whenever we have to use it over here, the curly braces, then people may be able to know that is a multi-value attribute. Right, so composite attribute, we have to use the parenthesis. Multi-value attribute that contain more than one value for a given entity instance, that is a multi-value attributes. So if we are using another notation, so for that one we have to use the double line oval or ellipse to represent the multi-value. So here imply names, job, address, skill, that is a multi-value attribute that contain more than one value for a given entity instance, so that is a multi-value attributes. Now, next one we are having stored attribute and derived attribute. The attribute whose value can be calculated from related attribute, that is called derived attribute. That we are having one attribute is there, the value of that one attribute is calculated from another attribute, that is called derived attribute. That here we are having date of employed, joining date is one attribute, that is a store attribute. The value of this one attribute is stored in a database. But year employed, we see that what is the experience of employed. So value of this one attribute is calculated from the dead employed attribute. Date of birth is a store attribute, and we can calculate the value of age from the date of birth attribute. The data not actually stored in the database but derived from the other attribute that is stored in the database. So data related to the year employed is not stored in the database. That can be calculated when needed. Mean how? System dot minus date employed. So that will calculate the year of employed. Store attribute value are stored in the database. So whenever we are having the derived attributes, we can represent the derived attribute. To represent the derived attribute, we have to use the dashed ellipse. So here dash ellipse, that is used to represent the derived attribute. To represent the multi-value attributes, we are using it over here double ellipse. Now, and normally if we are using it over here Microsoft Visio or another notation, so for over there in that one notation we have to use the bracket to represent the derived attributes graphically. Okay, now we are having identifier and partial identifier. Whenever to identify the record of, to identify uniquely identify the record of strong int type. For that one, we have to use the identifier. To represent the identifier, we have to use underlines. And partial identifier, to represent uniquely identification of the weak entry type, we have to use the partial identifier. And for that one, we have to use the double underline. So here, student ID, that is the identifier attribute. Flight numbers, flight ID, identifier, like dependent ID, that is considered as a partial identifier, that is double underlines. So that all about the attributes. So here we discuss the different types of the attributes. So over there, simple attribute, composite attribute, single value attribute, multi value attribute, store attribute, derived attribute, identifier, and partial identifiers. In next video, we will discuss the concept of relationship between the different type of entity types. Thanks for watching video.